everybody. Welcome back to the video series. So today I was inspired by our trip last week. We went to swim with the humpback whales and the silverback, which was amazing, but inspired to share and start a new video series as part of our subscription. So that is called image editing. And you can guess what we're gonna cover in this. I use Adobe Lightroom and I'm going to be sharing one, some of the ways that I edit my photos, showing you my workflow from beginning to end, and then also edit some of your photos. So send me those photos, raw files, unedited, and then I'll show you how I would approach editing that photo. Of course, editing is very subjective. People have different beliefs in how to approach it, whether you should manipulate certain things, whether you shouldn't, whether you should boost saturation, whether you like no saturation. There's a lot of subtleties here. So this is really my workflow, the way I do it, and the way I would approach these photos. So definitely send in your photos. But in the meantime, I have selected this shot of a humpback mother and a little calf. So it's a great moment. They were just swimming, coming up to the surface for a breath. So I was really excited about the moment and capturing this shot, actually as a whole series of shots. But we'll go through and edit this one. The first thing I see off the bat is that, you know, the water's a little hazy. So I think we wanna bring out some detail. We wanna bring out, you know, a little more sharpness and clarity. We also want to play with the color a little bit. You know, I'm a big fan of adding some color back, some of the color we might see with strobes or video lights or closer to the surface, and adjust and play with it there. So, you know, with that said, let's get started. So in Lightroom, one of the first things I will always do is apply my lens corrections. So we'll jump down in the bottom right side of the develop module, and we're gonna look at these profile corrections. So every lens has some natural barrel distortion, vignetting, and things like that as part of it. But the cool thing with Lightroom is that if you click this profile corrections, you're gonna see that Adobe can read the lens you're using, the camera you're using, and it will apply corrections that they've determined is best for getting rid of that barrel distortion and that vignetting, which is really cool. So one of the things here, I'll always apply it for macro photos. For fisheye lenses, I generally never apply it because I actually like the warp and that fisheye perspective. If you apply this lens correction, you might flatten the image on the fisheye, which takes away from that, you know, big fisheye effect. The wide angle lens I'm using is kind of a hybrid. It's wide, but it's not quite like a fisheye, but it's not a flatter image like a macro image. So you'll notice when I click this, that one, you know, now it's off, the edges are a little darker. I click it, the edges lighten up, some of that distortion is gone, which is really cool. But I'm also looking at the subject, and with it, the subject seems to flatten out just a little bit as I'm shooting like this when I apply the lens corrections. So what I'm thinking in this particular shot is to leave the lens corrections off, and then I'll adjust the vignetting around the edges later on and just make that more of a subtle thing. And this is more particular to this ambient light type photography, but in this particular case, let's leave it off. Remove chromatic aberration. So that's more of an issue with smaller compact cameras. It's a bit of a color bordering, especially on the outsides and corners of the image. It's not as prevalent in mirrorless and DSLR cameras, but always keep that on. It's never going to hurt. It's always going to help if you do have any sort of aberration in there. So the next thing I'll do in my editing process is to start going through the presence box within the basic box here. There we go, basic. So this is my effort to turn the flat, kind of dull raw file into Brent's custom version of a JPEG. So I'm going to add some presence back in here. Let's see. You know, we don't want to overdo this. We want to be really careful. You know, maybe somewhere right about here is good. So 40. One of the cool things with these sliders is we can click and drag. We can double click to reset right there. We can also type in the numbers themselves. So we can type in 40 here, and that's really cool. So multiple ways to move the sliders, which is fun. So we've got that clarity at 40. You know, I think the exposure might be a little dark. So let's go up to the exposure, bump that up a little bit. And I'm always watching the histogram here to see where that exposure lies. So let's bump it up a little more because I do want to add some contrast, you know, so it's a little light there. Okay, so 0.65 of a stop. That looks good for now. Again, keeping in mind that I'm going to work on this contrast. Dehaze is another interesting tool. You can see what it does is it starts to add a lot more contrast and sharpening and saturation and things like that at the pixel level. What I like to do is go very light on dehaze, even though it's tempting to crank it, and then I'll adjust some of those factors through the individual sliders later on. So for this sake, you know, let's just do a little bit of dehaze right in here. I'm a bigger fan of more vibrance than saturation. You know, we always want to be careful with a shot like this that's just got so much blue. You know, we don't want to oversaturate it. So, you know, that looks good to me right about here. Let's pull down the blacks a little bit, right like this. Okay, now we're getting some more contrast. Maybe let's work on these basic shadows here. Okay, pull that down a little. Let's look at some of the highlights. And one of the things to notice here as we're adjusting the basic tone curve is that all of these sliders correspond with the histogram, which I'm always watching. So the blacks on the far left are right here. Then we move into the shadows, we move into the main exposure, we move into the highlights, and then finally we move into the whites. So notice as we make these adjustments, the histogram is changing and you're really moving that curve along depending, you know, on the adjustment you're making. So this one, I definitely want to punch some blacks pretty well, you know, because we don't have a lot of contrast. So, you know, this is looking good at the moment. I kind of like that. Let's work some more. We want to be careful of the highlights here on the fins. These are very bright. And I'm going to turn on this tone clipping here. And you'll see that if I crank the highlights, it's going to tell me that it's overexposed. Right there, you see all that red? That's a highlight alert showing me, hey, we're past the white point where the pixels are just showing pure white and there's no data there. There's gonna be nothing besides just white pixels. So that's something we always want to avoid when adjusting these. So you can turn this on individually, the highlights or the blacks. You can also hit J on the keyboard, which will turn the highlights on and off as well. So something to keep in mind as you're adjusting, you know, the highlights and the whites and the blacks and things like that. So let's pull some of these darks down again, looking for some more contrast, maybe a little more on the shadows. Here we go. Now let's pull the lights up a little bit. So what we're doing is we're adding contrast. Here we go. Okay, so we've got some good contrast in here. One thing you can always do to adjust and see what you've done so far is hit the slash key on your keyboard, which is slash. There we go. So before, after, before, and after. There's other ways to see before and after too. You can click on this double Y down here, click that, hit the tab key to make the sidebars disappear, and now we've got another before and after view so we can see what happened before and after. We've certainly got a lot more contrast, vivid color. I like that I increased the exposure a bit. You know, these fins are still a little bright and the image is still a little blue for me right now. So let's keep working on that. I'm gonna hit tab to bring the sidebars back. And I'm gonna go back to full screen for editing. And this is what I'm working with here. So what we want to take a look at now are some of these highlights. And I'm gonna turn on my highlight clipping here. Let's pull them down a little bit. We don't wanna take away contrast too much. So maybe a little bit, we start to see a little more definition in the fin. Let's go back up to the basic box and pull the whites down. And remember, that's the very brightest part of the histogram. So we're gonna take that down. And we'll drag it just a little bit. And there we go. So now we've got a much softer color in the whites right here, which I like. I think that's pretty cool. And these are kind of the basic adjustments. We can keep tweaking and adjusting, but you know, for now, I think that's pretty good. What I'm going to address right now actually is looking at some of the color. We've got this very blue image, which if that's what you like, because that's what we saw underwater, great, that is awesome. But I'm gonna try and add a little color in here and show you one of the side effects of trying to add color in post. And up at the top here, notice I'm hovering over this eyedropper tool called the White Balance Selector, or W. Hit that W key, boom, it pulls it right up. And what we want to do is pick a neutral point or a white or a flat gray in the frame. And that's going to tell Lightroom to automatically adjust the white balance for that point. So this looks pretty neutral. I'm going to click and boom, that white balance just changed. So that is pretty cool. That is Lightroom based making a decision on the white balance, the color temp based on that point I selected. So that is pretty cool. Let's turn that off for now. I like it. Let's look at before, after, before, after. But you know what? Now that I'm seeing this, I think I introduced too much red into the frame. We can see all the red up here in the right corner. So what we're going to do is pull this tint down a little bit. You notice these changed a little bit when we made the adjustment. So I'm gonna drop the reds. This is going to affect the gray, as you can see in the whales, but you know, that's just, there's always gonna be a little give and take. So here we go, that's kind of cool. We've got some nice grays. We've minimized some of the red just a little bit. Let's make this a little more blue just to help, you know, create a little less red. There we go. So it's a little more natural. Again, here's our before, here's our after. You know, really cool. Now this image is getting some more pop. I think what I might try and do here is let's pull the blacks down a little bit. You know, there we go. Okay, and you know, in doing that, I think maybe we can increase the darks a little bit. So I'm going back down to the tone curve. And what you can do on the tone curve is adjust the sliders like we did before, but you can also grab the tone curve itself. So now that's shadows, now I'm in the darks. I'm gonna grab the tone curve and just pull it up a little bit. So there we go. Now that increased the watercolor a little bit. That's nice, I'm liking that so far. We still have some red up at the top that I'll get to later. But one of the things I want to do is maybe this blue is just a little too dark. So what I'm going to do is come into the highlight saturation luminance, and I'm going to take the luminance of the blue, and we can adjust the blue slider from here. You know, darker, more of a lighter blue. You know, okay, that's looking cool. It's lightening up quite a bit. That's pretty fun. Let me double click to reset. What we could also do is grab this circle right here, and all you have to do is click an area of the frame, and that will pull up that color and that feature based on the combination of colors. So if you have something like a skin tone, that could be a combination of oranges and reds and browns. So, you know, this will pull all those colors up for you in the way, you know, you might see here. So here we've got blues came up and a little bit of aqua. So, you know, that was actually a good move there. So luminance, I think that's fine. Let's just play for fun. Let's look at the saturation. Let's pull that down just a bit on the blue. You know, maybe I actually like more saturation up for the top. So let's reset that. Don't want to mess with that too much, at least for me right now. So that's looking good. So here's our before, here's our after. So a lot of pop. One of the things I want to do now is start doing some local adjustments. So we did a lot of the global changes, but now let's go to some of the smaller stuff. So I see a little piece of backscatter right here and right here. And notice these things are a bit red, and that's because we adjusted the white balance. So any particulate backscatter and things like that are going to turn red. They were white, now they're red when we make some of these adjustments. So what I'm going to do is go here to our spot removal tool, the clone heal brush. I can use a bracket tool or my mouse to decrease the size, and I'll set this to heal, opacity 100%, click, and here we go. Now that spot is gone. So it has been fixed, done, we can see it's out. So let's fix our other backscatter point right here. Let's grab the tool, smaller, click, done. So here we go. Now we've gotten rid of those two pieces of backscatter. So the last local adjustment I'm gonna look at is some of the reds here up at the top, which I hate when the white balance is adjusted but there's red in the frame. It's just not at all what we're seeing underwater. I'd rather lose some of that color to get rid of the reds than have the color with the reds. It's just, I don't like it. So we're gonna paste on a layer right here. I know that was a strong, strong opinion. And we're just going to paint. And I can turn on selected mask overlay. And we'll see that I'm painting right here. Okay, cool. So, you know, you can start to see the red, which is my layer mask where I've been painting. So, you know, do a little more in here, make sure we're getting rid of all the reds. Cool, so now I've created a layer in here very easily in Lightroom. And what I'm gonna do is adjust the color of that. So I'm gonna pull down the reds and the purples in that layer. And watch that change. We've lost a lot of those reds. Let me paint up here a little more because we have a lot more red here, maybe a bit here. Cool, so now we've lost a lot more of that reds. Let's make this a little bluer, get rid of the yellows, kind of drop down the color temp. So now we're getting rid of a lot of those reds. I'm gonna paint this effect a little heavier, strengthen that layer. And there we go. So now we've painted that. Let's look at our before image, our after image. And I like that. So that might be where I'll stop here. Sometimes I might tweak and edit some more. But in terms of editing, I like that. So let's look at the side by side once again. Tab. Now we can see what we've got. The first shot, the second shot. Definitely like the second shot better. It's got a lot more going on, a lot more detail. So one of the things I'll do also is start to rate the photo. So I think this is a good one. I'm going to put 3 stars on it. And what that's gonna allow me to do later is in my metadata in Lightroom search, I'm gonna search humpback whales in my keywords. I can do 3 stars and avoid all my bad whale shots at 0, 1, and 2 stars and only go to 3 stars and above. So I've edited that. I know it's a photo I like. It's 3 stars and I'll be able to find it again. So I hope that was helpful, you guys. A little insight into my editing process. Again, send me your photos and I'll edit them on future videos. And feel free, as always, to ask me any questions. Thanks, and see you on the next video.